Hey guys, we'll take up one more problem on convolution integral. This time the input sequence is e power minus 3 into some combination of unit step function, and impulse response h of t is e power minus 2 u of t. Okay, so we shall try to sketch x of t and h of t first. So how does an x of t looks like? It is actually combination of two signals, right? One is exponentially decreasing signal, because we have minus here, e power minus 3t. And this exponentially decreasing signal is multiplied with a rectangular pulse, which is nothing but u of t minus 2. Okay, so first we'll try to sketch this signal. How does this u of t minus 2 looks like? So u of t is this. It starts from 0, and u of t minus 2 is u of t shifted right 2 times. So 0, 1, 2. This is 1, this is 2. So u of t shifted right 2 times. Okay, so this signal is subtracted with this signal. So what do we get? So what is the result of u of t minus 2? So from minus infinity to 0, amplitude of the first signal is 0, and from minus infinity to 0, amplitude of the second signal is 0. So therefore, from minus infinity to 0, the resultant sequence is 0, right? From 0 to 2, amplitude of the first signal is 1. From 0 to 2, amplitude of the second signal is 0. So 1 minus 0 is 1. So from 0 to 2, it is 1. Right. So from 2 to infinity, amplitude of the first signal is 1. From 2 to infinity, amplitude of the second signal is 1. So 1 minus 1. So we get 0 from 2 to infinity. Okay. So this is a rectangular pulse, what we have for u of t minus 2. And this signal is multiplied with what? Exponentially decreasing signal. Right. It is like this. So this is t. So when these two, this is exponentially decreasing signal, e power minus 3t, this is e power minus 3t, this signal is e power minus 3t, and this signal is u of t minus 2. When I multiply these two, 1 times this signal for t varying from 0 to 2, so 1 times this signal, so what I get is this signal itself, right? Till for t varying from 0 to 2, and amplitude at t is equal to 0 is 1. Fine. So this signal is nothing but e power minus 3t into u of t minus 2. Right. So what is this? This is x of t. Right. So therefore, how does an x of t looks like? X of t is exponentially decreasing signal for t varying from 0 to 2. Which amplitude is 1 at t is equal to 0. Okay, and what about h of t? So h of t is, it's an exponentially decreasing signal, right? It goes till plus infinity. At t is equal to 0, amplitude is 1. So this is t. Right? So this is x of t sequence, and it is h of t sequence. So what is the next step? This was actually step 1. In step 1, what I need to do is I need to change the independent variable, right? So I have to plot x of tau 0, 2, this is tau, this is x of tau, and I have to plot h of minus tau. So since this is h of minus tau is mirror image of h of t, right? Like this. This goes till minus infinity. This is tau, this is h of minus tau. Fine. Okay, what is the next step? So now I need to keep both the sequence in, both the signal in same independent variable tau. So x of tau is this 0 to 2, this is x of tau, and h of minus tau, it is like this. Okay, so this is h of minus tau. Say I keep h of minus 2 somewhere at tau is equal to minus 5. And what is the controlling index? It is t, right? Why? Why it is t? Because the signal is starting at 0. This end of the signal is 0, so this therefore it is t. If this adds somewhere in 2, then it will be t plus 2. If this has somewhere in minus 2, this will be t minus 2. Since it is at 0, it is t. Okay, fine. Now, this when I move the slider from minus infinity till just before 0, there won't be any overlap, right? So, therefore, t for t less than 0, when I say t less than 0 is nothing but I am moving this slider from minus infinity till just before 0. So, what is the output? Y of t is equal to 0. Why? Because no overlap. No overlap of x of tau and x of t minus 2. Fine. Next. Now, I will move further right. So, from this, I moved from minus infinity to till t less than 0. Now, I will move it further right. So, I will move it further right. Say, I move at somewhere around 1. Tau is equal to 1. So, this is 0, this is 2, and this is t. Right? And the overlap region starts from 0 and ends at, depending upon where I keep this slider t. Right? So, what is the condition here? So, for t is greater than or equal to 0, since I did not include 0 here, I will include 0 here. Okay, and till where I can move? T greater than or equal to 0, till where I can move? Till I can move to t, tau is equal to 2, right? So, t is less than or equal to 2. So, or combined I can write it as in between 0 to 2. Fine. So, there is this upper boundary for this slider to move further right. Okay, I can move it only from 0 to 0. This is another, this is one of the overlapping region, right? Which we saw actually in details in convolutions, some problems. If you want, you can go through that problem. Okay. So, for this, what is y of t? Y of t is equal to what? Integrating from minus infinity to infinity, x of tau, h of t minus tau, d tau, right? So, y of t is equal to integrating from 0 to t, right? 0 to t. And t is varying from 0 to 2. What is the value of x of tau? X of tau is this, right? And what is x of tau? So, x of t is e power minus 3t. Therefore, x of tau is e power minus 3 tau. Anyhow, this is 1, right? This is 1. This sequence is 1. So, I don't have to write consider the sequence. But this is e power minus 3 tau, right? So, instead of writing x of t, I will write it as e power minus 3 tau. Okay. Now, what is h of t? See, h of t is what? E power minus t, right? Therefore, what is h of t minus tau? It is nothing but e power minus of t minus tau, right? So, instead of writing h of tau, t minus tau, I will write it as e power minus of t minus tau and d tau. Fine. So, y of t is equal to integrating from 0 to t e power minus 3 tau. I'll split this exponential e power minus t into e power minus into minus plus tau d tau. So, this e power minus t has nothing to do with this integration with respect to tau. So, I can take it out. Okay, so I'll write it here. So y of t is equal to e power minus t integrating from 0 to t. This is e power minus 3 tau plus e power minus 3 tau into e power tau. It is nothing but minus 3 tau plus 1 tau, which is nothing but e power minus 2 tau d tau. Okay. So y of t is equal to e power minus t. What is the integration of e power minus 2 tau with respect to tau? It is nothing but e power minus 2 tau divided by coefficient of tau is minus 2 and the limit is 0 to t, right? So, y of t is equal to e power minus t, take minus 1 by 2 out, I end up with e power minus 2 tau with the integration limit 0 to t, right? So, y of t is equal to e power minus t into minus 1 by 2. So, upper limit is e power minus 2t minus lower limit is e power 0, which is 1. Right? So, this is nothing but if I take this minus sign inside, what do I get is e power minus t by 2 into 1 minus e power minus 2. Okay, this is the system output for t varying from 0 to 2. Okay. Now another overlapping region we need to consider. So far we moved from minus infinity till 2, right? Now I need to move further right more till it goes to infinity. So next case is this is 0, this is 2 tau. I moved it till here, so I'll move it till further right. So I take it here. So this is now t, right? This is tau. This is x of tau, and this is h of minus tau. What is the overlapping region here? Now overlapping region is 0 to 2. So from here onwards, whenever we move the slider till infinity also, the overlapping portion will be remain same 0 to 2. Okay. So therefore, so t is greater than 2. In the previous case, I did here I included 2, so I am excluding 2 here. So t is greater than 2 till infinity. I can move till infinity, right? So what is y of t? Y of t is equal to integrating from what is the overlapping region 0 to 2 x of tau h of t minus tau d tau. So y of t is equal to integrating from 0 to 2. What is x of tau? It is nothing but same as this, right? E power minus 3 tau into e power minus t minus tau. But this will not change. E power minus 3 tau into e power minus of t minus tau d tau. So whatever may be the overlapping region, these two terms remains the same for, okay? So y of t is equal to integrating from 0 to 2 e power minus 3 tau e power minus t e power tau d tau. So I can take it out. Y of t is equal to e power minus t integrating from 0 to 2 e power minus 2 tau d tau. Right? So y of t is equal to e power minus t integrating of that is e power minus 2 tau divided by minus 2 limit is 0 to 2. So y of t is equal to e power minus t. I'll take minus 1 by 2 out. So e power minus 2 tau for the limit 0 to 2. So y of t is equal to e power minus t minus 1 by 2 into upper limit is e power minus 4 minus e power 0 is 1, lower limit is 1. So y of t is equal to, I'll take this minus inside, so e power minus t by 2 into 1 minus e power minus 4. So this is the output for t greater than 2. So therefore, if I write combinedly all the case, so it is what? So if for t is less than 0, y of t equal to 0. So it is 0 for t less than 0. For t in between 0 and 2. For t in between 0 and 2. What is the output? E power minus t by 2, 1 minus e power minus 2t, right? So e power minus t by 2, 1 minus e power minus 2t. Okay. Now for t greater than 2, what is the output? E power minus t by 2 into 1 minus e power minus 4. So this is the system output.